Hi there, and welcome back to VFX Rendering. In this video, we're going to explore cloth tearing simulation in Cinema 4D. Cloth tearing is the effect of fabric ripping apart, and it's often used to add realism and drama in animation or VFX. Today, I'll show you how to set it up using the cloth tag and a vertex map, so you can control exactly where and how the fabric breaks. Let's get started. First, we will use the male bust model with a triangular mesh. You can easily download this model from the asset browser. Once imported, duplicate the object to create an outer surface. We will create the outer surface using the node modifier. In the node environment, we add a polygon bevel node with offset equals 0.6 centimeters and inset equals 0%. Enable select per step and use island, then create parameters for offset and inset. Add a subdivide node, set to loop mode and smooth. Use a quad remesh node with polygon scale equals 50% and adaptive enabled. Add an if node to switch between triangular and quad mesh. Once the outer surface is ready, assign it a different color so it's easy to recognize in the viewport. Next, create a vertex map for the outer surface. Start with a spherical field. Set size equals 10 centimeters, inner offset equals 75%, and contour mode equals curve. Position it at X equals negative 30 centimeters, Y equals 90 centimeters. Add a freeze modifier field layer in grow mode, with radius equals 3 centimeters and effect strength equals 7%. Apply a random field with animation speed equals 100%. Contour mode equals curve, and set blending mode to overlay. Add a curve modifier field layer. Choose Gauss shape. Finally, use a decay modifier in minimum mode with effect strength equals 75%. Let's move on to the cloth tag. Apply it to the outer surface. Set friction equals 0.2, thickness equals 1 centimeter, and override damping equals 2%. Then enable cloth tearing with tear past equals 101%, and use the vertex map we created for control. Set min tear past equals 100%. In the mix animation tab, enable with pin, set influence equals 10%, and again use the same vertex map. Also, enable follow shape. Don't forget to set gravity equals 0 centimeters in simulation settings. Now let's add some effects. Add a wind force, set speed equals 200 centimeters, keep other values default. In transform, set px equals negative 50 centimeters, RH equals 445 degrees. RP equals 170 degrees. RB equals negative 125 degrees. Apply the vertex map in the field tab. Add a collider tag to the male bust model. The outer layer will tear apart under wind force and drift away. Apply turbulence force. First one with strength equals 15 centimeters, scale equals 50%, frequency equals 50%. Add a second turbulence with strength equals 5 centimeters, scale equals 10%, frequency equals 75%. Add a rotation force, set RP equals negative 90 degrees, angular speed equals 50. In the node modifier, rotate the triangular mesh surface. Adjust or keyframe parameters until you're satisfied. Once done, cache the cloth tag for better performance. And finally, apply a cloth surface to smooth the result. And that's it. We've just walked through the full process of creating a cloth tearing simulation in Cinema 4D using the cloth tag combined with a vertex map. From setting up the base mesh to caching and refining the cloth surface, now you have the tools to create this effect in your own projects. If you found this tutorial helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and stay tuned for more tutorials from VFX Rendering. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.